Grandma's Kitchen.
There's a fiddle tune and a wooden spoon while she's stirring and singing. There's friends leaving our family land, and then the phone's usually ringing. No matter who you are or what you've done, everything's forgiven. And ain't it good to be in Grandma's Kitchen?
Hello, everybody. Mary Janet here from Tunes and Wooden Spoons, and welcome back to the Sunday afternoon shows. It's great to be here, and that opening song was from a friend of mine. Her name is Mary Campbell from Scotland, lives in Edinburgh, and we're celebrating Bobby Burns Day today. I think tomorrow is his official birthday, but today we're going to celebrate Bobby Burns. So I'm wearing my Kepuk tartan for my clan of the Kepuk MacDonalds. So I hope you've had a wonderful week. This is going to be an exceptional show today. I am so delighted to be here. First of all, I'm going to go back and tell you a little bit about Mary Campbell. Mary is spelled M-A-I-R-I. And Mary is a beautiful singer, a beautiful fiddle player, and a great dancer, step dancer. And she's from Scotland, as I said. And she recorded Auld Lang Syne many years ago. And her and her husband, David Francis, were just brought it to the world stage, really. And she's been here for the Celtic Colors Festival, as well as he. And she's celebrated, that song, I believe, was in the movie soundtrack for Sex and the City. And she was also celebrated by being invited to a huge celebration when Sean Connery retired, or he was being honored for something. And it's actually on YouTube. You could find it there. And you'll see Mary there singing on stage, singing Auld Lang Syne, and he, being formerly from Scotland, being very moved by that performance as they brought her over as a special guest from the homeland. So anyway, Mary and I taught at the Keolis Festival on South Uist a few times, and they are wonderful people. And every time I go to Scotland, I get to see her, and she's a beautiful singer. So today is really, really special in so many ways, let alone Bobby Burns. But today I have an amazing special guest. Well, I have two guests. I have a musical guest, which I'll introduce later. But we have a guest from just up the road, and her name is Theresa MacDonell. So Theresa, I'm going to get you to come up here in the kitchen, and she is my teacher this week. So Theresa, this is but my lovely, lovely lady. Can you see yourself there on camera? She is a friend to many, and a mother of seven children just like me, and 17 grandchildren.
Yes.
And one great grandchild, and just a beautiful person, and full of fun and full of tricks and all that it brings, aren't you?
Yes.
So I'm going to put this on you, Theresa. And so the way we're going to do it today, now I was up visiting Theresa, and I watched her make the her Bonnach, which she's made many, many times over the years. And today I am going to be, she's going to be watching me put it together. And then I'm going to give it to her to take over and put in the pan, and put we'll put it in the oven, and we'll just have some great conversation, and just have some fun.
Yeah.
And you're going to tell me if I'm doing it right or wrong.
Indeed, I will.
You will.
Yes.
You? See, she's that's her. She'll tell it like it is.
Yes.
So there's lots of people watching. There's over 700 people watching.
Oh. That's
I shouldn't tell you that.
No. But anyway, I'd like to tell you a little bit about this wonderful person. You were a Beaton before you were married.
Yes.
And you grew up in Glencoe, was it?
Glencoe.
And how many in your family was there that you were? How many?
12.
Brothers? There were 12, and you were one. You were a twin.
Yes.
And how? Where did
six
you fit?
Six boys and six girls.
Get out of here.
And I was a twin.
Okay.
The youngest.
The youngest were twins.
Yes.
They stopped.
Twin girls.
Oh my
yes.
God!
Yeah.
And is your twin still alive?
No.
She passed away.
Passed away.
So how many?
It's just two living.
Two left. Okay.
Yeah, myself and Kay.
Is that right? And Kay's in Dartmouth, is it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And hope Kay is getting to watch today.
She is.
Is she?
Yes.
Oh, that's awesome. Well, Kay, just hold on a second now. I forgot to unplug my phone. Just my brother-in-law calling, so I just kind of hung up on him, so it's okay. I'll explain later. So anyway, 12 in a family. You probably lived on a farm.
Oh, yes.
And
lots of work.
Lots of hard work.
Yes.
And was Gaelic the language in your home?
No, both.
Both English and Gaelic.
Yeah.
We'll hear a little bit more of that Gaelic later,
maybe. Yeah. Yes,
we
indeed.
Will. Right, we
yes.
will. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So we're gonna start here. I'm going to get myself together. I'm just gonna set your oven now. If you're baking with us, set your oven for 375, and I'm just gonna wash my hands because I'll be doing some work here with this, and I'll leave Teresa in charge of the camera. So make sure that nobody says anything mean or anything there, right?
Okay.
And I'll
okay.
I'll be right back.
I'll watch.
That's good. Here now, give it a little wipe there. So, Teresa shared her recipe with me, and I want to get you to push over just a little bit, and I'll be in the way here, and I'm going to see if I can. Bring this out a little bit and down so you can see us. Hello, Teresa from Winnipeg. Donna Skull. Oh, there's over 800 watching now. Well, well, well. Isn't that something?
Oh, boy.
There now. We're going to...
Boy, oh, boy.
So you keep an eye on me. So this is what I have today. I haven't used my sifter in a long time, but she uses her sifter for the all-purpose flour. So we're going to start with that, a nice big bowl and the sifter. So I'm going to start with 4 cups of flour. Let me get the recipe
three.
In front of me here.
Three.
Oh, three. It's 3 cups. See, she's correcting me already. 3 cups of flour and 1 cup of whole wheat.
Whole wheat.
Gosh,
that's right.
There we now. Okay.
Yeah.
You'll just have to keep me in line because sometimes I go astray. So I'll put, there's 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I guess I'll do this. It's been a long time since I had it. Use this.
You're doing good.
Am I doing okay?
Really good.
There now. There's the last of it. And so there's our 3 cups of flour. And then I have whole wheat flour in here. And it's 1 cup of whole wheat flour. But I don't sift this one, right?
No.
Okay. All right. So far, so good, Teresa?
Very good.
Okay. All right. And I'm just going to stir that around with my hand.
Right.
That's what you did.
That's right.
We're good at using our hands.
Yes.
Yes, they're good tools to have. All right. Now, we're going to put in 6 teaspoons of baking powder. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, five, six. So far, so good.
Pinch of salt.
A pinch of salt. And I'll just put it in the palm of my hand like this. That's what you did?
That's what I did.
Okay. And then it says 3 teaspoons of white sugar. Is that good?
That's right.
One, two, three. Now that's all the dry ingredients. And I'll just mix that up with my hand.
Good.
Good?
Good.
Okay. So now, Teresa uses oil. But if you're out there and you didn't want to use oil, you can use, the recipe also says you could have a half a cup of shortening or a half a cup of lard or a half a cup of butter if they want it.
Yes.
But this is what you've gravitated to. You like the way that this mixes up, right?
Yes.
So get a half a cup of oil. This is just vegetable oil or canola oil will work.
Whatever you have.
Whatever you have in, right?
That's right.
All right. Okay. There we go. I'm going to put that in the bowl. And then 2 cups of milk. The recipe calls for a little less milk than that, but you said 2 cups is better.
Yes.
Okay. Mix it in with the oil. That's 1 cup.
That's good.
Another cup. And we're good. Okay. And just mix that up.
That's right.
Okay. Tell ya. We'll pour that in the center. And what? I'll just mix it like this?
Just mix it up well.
Okay. Now, Teresa's going to take over after I get it out onto the little baking sheet here. And we're going to use what Teresa brought her pan with her. It's a cast iron fry pan. But that worked really good when we made it at your place. It was just perfect. And I bet you a lot of you out there saw her beautiful stove. If you didn't, you look at an earlier post on my page and you'll see. Do you think that's mixed enough now? And I should sprinkle a little more flour.
A little more flour.
Okay.
Yeah. Then it'll be easier to mix.
Just mix it up. Okay. All right. I'll just kind of. Is that good?
That's good.
Now, let's see. Because it is pretty wet.
Yeah, a little more.
A little more. How's that?
That's looking good.
Okay. Well, just hold on a second. I'm losing my tartan scarf here. It's falling off my shoulder. All right. So, now, Teresa, I'll put a little on here. Yeah,
that's right.
Okay.
A little round.
Is that enough?
That's good.
All right. Now we'll put the... It's basically like a biscuit recipe, right?
Exactly.
You know, and you've ended up with one great big biscuit, right?
Yes.
Okay, I'll put that over here. Now, Teresa, I'm going to turn it over to you. Now there's flour there, and I'll put, this is Teresa's frying pan. Do you know how big that is? Is it a 10 inch or something?
I would say a little more.
Okay, I'll let you do the next part. So she's sprinkling some flour in the bottom of the frying pan. And she'll work with that. In the meanwhile, I'm going to get a measuring tape. And I'm going to see if how big that frying pan is in diameter. It's about 10 3/4 inches. So Perfect. So you're kneading it a little bit?
A little bit, because it's still kind of...
wet.
Wet.
I'm punching it down. Ah, look at the years of practice, huh? I hope everybody's taking note of this.
I bet they are.
Look at that. Here, I'll put it over here in front of the camera so everybody can see. So you're just putting it right in the center. And this works fine because I made it. And once I learned from Teresa, I made it myself on Friday and to see if I could, how it came out like on the stoneware pan. So I have a stoneware pan here that I'm just going to show you, just like a pizza pan. But it came out really good for me on this too.
It did.
And it's kind of the same idea.
Yes.
But you can use a cookie sheet, of course, right? Now, do you think that that's ready to go?
Wouldn't
it be a knife? Oh, yeah.
We'll have to make the...
So, Teresa's going to score it out. Not all the way through, just you're just going part of the way down, right?
Part of the way.
Okay. Now, how many of these would you say that you made over the years?
Oh, I couldn't tell you.
So we've preheated our oven to 375 and we're going to put it in the oven for 40 minutes. And we're just going to move to the living room very shortly.
There now.
That's shinikata.
Hinikachin.
Hinikachin. Lord, Lord, I'll be learning some Gaelic. And there's the master at work. What do you think? There's a little over 1,000 people watching. That's all because of you.
Hello.
Okay, I'm going to put this in the oven. There you go, for 40 minutes in my oven. So all the ovens are different. It was different at, it took a little longer in Teresa's oven. So I had to just practice on Friday to see how it went. So we're gonna move to the living room, we're gonna have some conversation, and we're gonna have some singing. So just hold on a second. Look, I'll take that apron off you now because you just, you're going to be relaxing from now on in.
Oh.
Your work is done. Your work is done. Now listen, before we go to the living room, when we were making the Bonnach.
Yes.
You were telling me about one time that you were teaching somebody how to make Bonnach.
Oh yes, my sister-in-law. She was home from Detroit.
Yeah.
And she came to visit me.
Right.
Of course, I made tea.
Yeah.
And I had a piece of Bonnach.
Yeah.
She turned and she said to me, oh, you'll have to show me how to make a Bonnach.
Okay.
I said, I will. So she went and she got a pen and she got a piece of paper and she's going to write everything down. So I started. And wait now.
You were putting it together and you were using your...
Yes.
Your fist.
I went and I was getting flour and I took one fist of flour and I put it in the bowl. Took another fist of flour, put that in the bowl. She said, wait. What size fist? Well, that was the end of the bomb.
Oh my God, that's great. Okay, you sit yourself in that nice rocking chair.
Okay.
And we'll turn this, put this in the oven for 40 minutes. Okay. And Teresa's washing her hands. And do you put milk on top of the, No. No, she doesn't put milk on the top and or brush it with milk before she puts it in the oven. It's just like a biscuit, dry like that. And I know, isn't that a great story? I just love it. Okay, I'm going to move you around to the living room, and we'll be joined by the lovely Rita Rankin. So there we have it. There's the lovely Rita Rankin. Now, I want to make sure that I get everybody in the shot. I'm actually going to have to get you to bear with me while I let the legs down on this tripod so I can get, I need to have them close up. All right. So how was that, Teresa? Your first claim to fame on the internet? Well, wasn't so bad?
It wasn't so bad, no.
Still online. Hello. Yeah.
Dude.
You're on air with me.
There now. Now they're sitting, it looks closer than you are. You're sitting a distance apart there, just with COVID and all of that. We want to make sure of that. But first of all, I'd like to introduce you to the lovely Rita Rankin. She is a beautiful singer of English songs and Gaelic songs. And we were talking about the Gaelic songs, and Teresa is thought of this song that they could sing together, and I think that that's a lovely idea. And the song is Chimi Vuam.
Yeah,
Chimi Vuam. And they're going to sing this song. And I'll give you a little more information on Rita a little bit later. But Rita is a Mabou girl, just like I am, of course. But she lives in Port Hawkesbury. And Rita has recorded music. Sometimes they get the confused with the other Rankin family, right? Mary has been, her and her sisters and her whole family are beautiful singers, and they come from Mabou Coal Mines. And then there's the other Rankin family, like Jimmy and Heather and Raylene and Cookie. But anyway, this lady can sing, you know, just her heart out, just a beautiful voice. So we're going to be enjoying a little bit of that, and Teresa is going to sing along, and you never know, I might join in on the chorus myself. So tell us about the song as much as you know, Rita.
Well, I think it was written by Alexander the Ridge,
who right.
lived up Mabou Ridge, and he moved over to Cape George, and the view he could see was all along Route 19. So he describes Craignish and Judick and Port Hood and Mabou,
and every verse has that community. You'll hear the words in Gaelic, but there'll be Craignish and Shuttick, right? Is that how you say
That's
it?
That's right.
And Shestico for Port Hood,
mm-hmm.
and how do you say Mabou? Vabou, something like that. Anyway, not me. I'm not that great at it, but. Teresa knows that song well, and she's going to sing along in the chorus. So I hope you enjoy, and I'll take it away. Rita, we'll get it started, and you'll join in on the chorus.
Right on.
Okay.
Chimi vuam fata vuam, chimi vuam rima vuam, chimi Cape Breton vuam, fata vuam paranta. He me cricken ish nan cruv lake a journey in our sun roof at the hardy do, yev chermoon on his bath. He me buam fata buam, he me buam me moam, he me cape right in the buam, fata buam maranda. He me shatik nam fer krui, he me bruik nam fer arst, bachlam he me shan li wur, lichia wan eche ba.
He me buam fata buam, he me buam rimura, he me keep retin ma buam, fata buam haranda.
He me ma buen hu, bishetu ik mogra, he me, I hope I messed up.
That's all right.
Mabuera, bishetu, ichmogra.
Kimi buam, pata buam, kimi buam, mimuam, kimi Cape Breton, mabuam, pata buam, paranta.
Kimi buam, fata buam,
kimi buam, rimuam, kimi Cape Breton, mabuam, pata buam, paranta.
Woohoo! Beautiful, beautiful voice. So I'm going to put Teresa on the spot here. You know, she looks so angelic and modest and humble, which she is. She is that. But she also plays some tricks. And last year on April Fool's Day, she played the meanest trick on her homemaker that would come in to help every, you know, so many times a week or whatever. So, Teresa, can you tell us what you did?
Yes, I did. This. Awful. I ran down to my bedroom and then I got in bed and put the clothes up around me tight. The homemaker came in. First thing I heard was, Teresa. No answer. Teresa. No answer. Out to the porch she went. Upstairs she went. Then she came down to the bedroom. I had my back turned. Teresa. I looked around and I said, April Fool. Well, if she didn't get mad at me.
Oh my God, she probably thought you were dead.
She did. It was awful. I didn't play any more tricks on them.
And you know what? You know, this lady is 88 years old. And isn't it great to be 88 years young? She is young at heart and just has so much to offer. And she is so loved by her children and her grandchildren. And I'm telling you. Thank you for being here. So anyway, we're going to keep
on
going.
Thank you for us.
I'm just so proud to have you with me. So now we're going to ask Rita, while that's in the oven, to sing us a song of your choice. Or first of all, before you sing, I want to tell you a little bit more about Rita. Rita, tell me how many were in your family.
15 kids.
15 kids. And we're saying, well, we have a lot, big family with 7, 15, her and her mom and dad, you know, just an amazing family and just so talented. So where did you come in the family?
Fourth youngest.
The fourth youngest. And how did you take up the singing, or was that just a natural happening that happened in your home?
Yeah, it was pretty natural, everybody. Kind of
sang. Had a good voice.
The radio, along
imagine
with church and yeah. In the car.
So yes, I know that you sang a lot in church. I know I've been to church in Melbourne, many funerals and church services. You're always there as your family. If there isn't one of you, there's two of you, or there's four of you, or whatever. And a few years ago, I had this concert in Mabou. It was a fundraiser to help kids go on a trip to Scotland. So I thought it would be a great idea to honor some talented people's mothers. So the concert series was called A Mother's Love. And so I would honor 4 mothers in the course of the show. And two of them were still living and 2 had passed on, but we would pay tribute to all of those 4 mothers, and we would divide the concert up into 4 sections, and each section honoring that particular mother. And so one of the mothers was her mom, Bernetta Rankin, because they had just a very talented family. But I think that might have been one of the first times you were all together kind of on stage, a lot of you. How many were you on that stage that night? Maybe 8 or so?
Yeah, together.
Some of the brothers and of course, the five or six sisters together. I don't know how many were on the stage that night.
Yeah, there was a crew.
Anyway, I swear we need to do a concert of just them sometime. Unbelievable talent. And it was just so nice. And to see them honor their mother in that way, it was just so beautiful. And it was all held at Strathspey Place, a performing arts center in Mabou that holds about 500 people, and it was full, and it was just such a nice tribute to the mothers that raised you and weren't really out there singing publicly themselves, but you guys had made it into that, and it was just so nice. So anyway, I want to hear more from Rita. She's one of my favorites, and I always love to listen to your voice. You've got a beautiful voice. So you take it away to a good song that we'll enjoy.
I'm going to do Kilkelly.
Ooh.
It's a series of letters written from a father to his son. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Your good friend, the schoolmaster, Pat McNamara, was so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. The house is so empty and sad. The crop of potatoes is sorely infected. A third to a half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married in June. And your mother says not to work on the railroad and be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1870, my dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble. I suppose that he never will learn. Because of the dampness, the snow, turf to speak of. And now we have nothing to burn. And Bridget is happy you named the child for her, although she's got six of her own. You say you found work, but you don't say what kind or when you'll be coming home. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1880, dear Michael and John, my son. I'm sorry to give you the very sad news that your dear old mother has gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly. Your brothers and Bridget were there. You don't have to worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. And it's so good to hear that Michael's returning with money he's sure to buy land. For the crop has been poor and the people are selling at any price that they can. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1890, my dear and loving son John. I suppose that I must be close on 80. It's 30 years since you've gone. Because of all of the money you've sent me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house, and Bridget's daughters are grown. And thank you for sending your family picture. They're lovely young women and men. They say that you might even come for a visit. Why What joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1892, my dear brother John. I'm sorry I didn't write sooner to tell you that father passed on. He was living with Bridget. He says he was cheerful and healthy right on to the end. And you should have seen him playing with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside a mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. He was a strong and a feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. And it's funny in the way he kept talking about you. He called for you at the end. So why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd all love to see you again.
Oh, my God.
Very nice.
That is such a beautiful song. I know that song. I actually had it on a cassette tape. And I don't know who got all of these letters. Do you know?
Peter Jones.
Jones? Okay.
He found the letters.
Found the letters and just want to see Rita there. Found the letters and just put them to that ballad, and it tells the sorrow and what was happening in Ireland at the time and over the years, and how the son went away and just he never did come back home, did he? You know, and the mourning of the parents to see that happened. But anyway, that's a beautiful, beautiful song. So thank you all for listening to and staying with us. Thank you so much. Doesn't she have a beautiful, everybody's saying, beautiful voice, beautiful
yes,
voice.
Yes, that's and, for sure.
And she certainly does.
I shouldn't be singing with you.
Indeed, you should. Did you, now, Teresa, did you have lots of Kayleys at your house when you were young?
Yes.
And what would you, well, you didn't, did you call it a Kaylee then? Or did you just say a party?
Party.
Or, yeah, a party.
Just a party, and you went from house to house to play cards.
Play cards, and then you'd have a big tea.
Oh, yes.
That was the big
tea, that was the
big thing.
Yeah.
You know? And tea consisted of maybe Bonnach.
And there were a lot of people around.
Yeah, of course. There were big families.
Big families.
Neighbors and
yes,
whatever.
Yes, indeed.
And did they sing English songs as well as Gaelic songs?
It was mostly Gaelic.
It was mostly
then.
Gaelic songs, yeah. And would you ever have any fiddlers in playing sometimes too?
Well,
just depended
just
on
depend.
On, depends.
Yeah.
Oh,
not too many.
Not too
fiddlers.
Many. But and did you dance yourself? Did you step dance yourself?
A little.
A little?
Not too much. And I do.
I bet. Did you go to square dances then?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, lots of square dances.
Walks miles to a square dance.
Imagine.
Yes.
And
thought nothing of it.
Thought nothing of it. And how much was it to get in, to pay?
Oh, maybe $1.50.
Would it be $1.50? Because
or a dollar.
Yeah, and probably less than that too. I can remember in Mabou going to square dances, and I only had to pay 25 cents.
Yeah, you did.
And yeah, that was it. That was just 25 cents,
yeah.
And then 50 cents. Then of course it increased with everything.
Yeah, maybe it would be a dollar, and you at that time it was a 50-cent piece.
Okay,
you'd have to give it to whoever you.
God, you never
got
see
the
a
ride.
50-cent piece anymore.
Back
you know?
Of a truck.
Yeah.
Then.
But
there was fun then.
There was lots of fun. Isn't
yes.
that great? Now, who would be do you remember who would be playing for the dances then? What fiddle players?
Well, Buddy, for
Buddy
one.
Buddy Bastard,
yes,
yeah.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. And could you remember if it was just four couples in a set then?
Oh, just four.
Just four.
Yes.
And was it more than three figures in a set?
Or just the three figures?
Three figures.
That's what you remember.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Two jigs and a reel.
Yeah, that's right.
Awesome. Awesome.
And they were good sets.
Oh, I bet.
Yes.
Oh, don't you know? Now, how did you meet your husband?
Oh, at a set.
In a square set?
A square set.
Yeah, is that
those
right?
Weren't too many.
Yeah,
no,
okay.
Indeed.
And he was always from Judic area?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And McWilliam.
Yeah, that's right.
And then you got married and had the seven children and moved from the original house, did you, that you were in first, to the house you're in now?
Yes.
Oh, you just love her. You'd love her house.
Yeah.
It's so pristine and well kept and nice big windows. You put the new windows in the house
at some point, and
she just lives on one level and she's quite content there by herself. And she has a marvelous family who are so good to her, as she says herself. So you had five girls and two boys.
Yes.
Five girls and two boys, and the two boys live really close, and they look after all the little fixings that have to be done.
Oh, yeah, taking in the wood.
Yeah.
And little chores like that.
And I'm telling you, the stove that she had in the kitchen that I posted a picture of, the heat that comes out of that stove, it was a Pioneer.
Yeah.
Pioneer stove.
Yeah.
Just incredible, incredible heat, beautiful stove.
Yeah.
You had that. You've had that most of your married life, have you? That stove?
Oh, not. Maybe just 40 years since
then. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well.
Yeah.
Okay. So, do you think we should hear another song from Rita?
Oh yes.
Let her go, Rita.
Just trying to think which one.
Yeah. So, who inspired you when you were younger? Like for learning. These songs are just songs that were sung in the house or that your father sang or teachers or what?
Well, we were in Gaelic singing group in school. We started singing Gaelic in grade three. So a lot of the Gaelic stuff we had learned through school.
But did you have Gaelic anyway from your father? Or?
No, Dad spoke it mostly on the phone or people that would visit.
Okay.
So it was the era where it was kind of petering out before. So
wasn't cool
to
do it, I guess. Yeah.
But my sister and brother, like, they're fluent.
Yes. So. Imagine.
Yeah. So it's nice that they carried it on.
Oh, 100%. Now, which brother?
John Philip.
Okay. Yeah.
And he'll go visit the older people, so he'll has the old dialect.
Retained, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome. Okay. You take it away. I'm going to check on the oven and...
Okay.
Check on the tea, put the kettle on. We have to have a cup of tea.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we'll get that ready in a few minutes, but let Rita sing a song.
Okay, I'm going to
check the Bonnach.
I'll check the Bonnach. I'm just going to have a peek. There's 17 minutes left. Oh, it's raising right up. It looks good.
Good.
Yep.
Okay, I'm going to try a more modern one, I guess. Adele.
I heard that you settled down, that you found a girl and you're married now. I heard that your dreams came true. Guess she gave you things I didn't give to you. Old friend, why you're so shy? Ain't like you to hold back or hide from the light. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away. I couldn't fight it. I'd hoped you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me, it isn't over. Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I'll beg, I remember you said. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes sometimes it hurts instead. You know how the time flies on me. Yesterday was the time of our lives. We were born and raised in a summer haze, bound by the surprise of our glory days. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away, I couldn't fight it. I hope you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg, I remember you say. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Nothing compares, no worries or cares, regrets and mistakes, their memories made. Who would have known how bittersweet this would taste? Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you. Don't forget me, I beg, I remember you said. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead.
Wow. There now.
I bet that's a good plan, though.
That's
for the
right.
Bonnach.
That's perfect.
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 Yes, I bet.
Yep, absolutely.
Well, this song.
Can you just believe how the voice that one has?
Oh, my dear.
Amazing. Now,
amazing.
Yeah, she can span many genres of music, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
You have a pretty famous granddaughter yourself. Miss Molly.
Oh, yes.
Molly, her granddaughter Molly, travels the world.
Yes, she does.
Well, not so much these days, but...
Not at all these days.
She's a young singer in a band that she's the lead of. It's called Always. And it's kind of A-L-V-V-A-Y-S, how
yes.
you spell it, but the two V's kind of look like a W. But, yeah, Molly would have... Well, Molly is her daughter Sally's daughter, but Molly's dad was John Morris Rankin, who was one of the Rankin family, who passed away. But yeah, Molly has made quite a career in music for herself. And if Molly is watching today, hi Molly, she's just
hi,
a sweetheart.
Molly. I think Sally was going to get a vault of her.
Oh, good. I hope she gets to see it. And she can always watch on the replay, too.
Yeah,
you
okay.
know? They can watch it again sometime. But, yeah, everybody's
all...
so proud of her because she even, she has another, Carrie Jean McClellan from Judik is
yes.
in that group, too.
Yes.
And I don't know the others, but so nice to see somebody local make it to the world stage. And her song Archie was just a great song. Yeah. I don't
yes.
know. It's just, it was so you have to look up Molly Rankin and Always, A-L, just put A-L-W-A-Y-S in. Maybe that would get you on Google, but she's a young, vibrant, wonderful songwriter and singer. And of course, she comes by naturally from both sides of the family for sure.
Yeah.
So Rita, are you going to be able to think of another one that you'd like to share with us?
Well, I was going to ask Teresa if she knew Fetavata.
Yes.
We can have more voices in
we
on
can
it.
Sing the chorus.
Yeah.
Okay, and yeah, you'll just put me to work in the kitchen yeah. while you guys go ahead and sing.
Okay.
That's
Did you guys sing it fast or slow growing up?
Kind of.
Faster? Like more of a lilt?
Yeah, yes.
Because we recorded that one 20 some years ago, I forget, but we did it slow.
Away.
Okay. Oh, we'll do a little more of a beat to it.
Yes.
Okay.
That's old.
Yeah, that's an old yeah.
old song.
And it's a sad song. He's yeah. waiting on the shoreline for her, or she's waiting on the shoreline for him to come home.
Good. You start.
Okay.
And I'll try. And
I don't.
Help.
I don't normally sing it fast, so I'll try.
She was going to start singing. Fadal Yo, do you know
not
that
not very
one?
Well. I sang it when I was little, but I don't remember
yeah.
all the words.
Do you know any of the verses of it?
Wait, no, what was I going to sing?
Fadal Yo.
Oh, Fadal Yo. No, just the game.
Just the chorus.
Chorus.
The chorus.
Yes.
Well, we'll get you to sing another one, another song of your choice.
Okay.
And there's about, what's left in here? There's about 6 minutes left, and I'll take it and show it to them.
Okay.
And but I'm getting the table prepared for our tea, because for any true Cape Bretoner from our side of the Cape Breton, I have some Cape Breton gold to go with our Bonnach, and that's a delicacy called homemade cheese or country cheese, aged, and it's not like you can buy it. It's like a bootleg thing, so. It's precious, but we saved some for today for Teresa, and she's pretty happy about that. So, you sing a
song.
Spend all your time waiting chance. For break that and make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough. And it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful relief. Memories seep through my veins. Let me be empty. Oh, and weightless. And maybe I'll find some peace tonight. In the arms of the angel. Fly away from here, from this dark old hotel room, and the earnestness that you fear. You are pulled from the wreckage of your silent reverie. In the so tired of the straight line, and everywhere you turn, there's vultures and thieves at your back. The storm keeps on twisting, keep on building the lies that make up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference, escaping one last time. It's easier to believe in this sweet madness, all this glory and sadness that brings me to my knees. In the arms of the angel, fly away from here, from this dark hotel room, and the earnestness that you fear. You are pulled from the wreckage of your silent reverie. In the arms of the angel, may you find some comfort. In the arms of the angel, may you find some comfort here.
Oh my God, Rita.
Wow.
Isn't that something else?
Isn't that
just so beautiful, so beautiful.
Wow.
Amazing. We have a couple of minutes left before we take it out of the oven, and we might just, you know, do just sin, because you're really not supposed to cut, you know, Bonnach right away, but just because of the show and the time and all of that, we might just leave it a few seconds. I've got the tea plates all ready and the napkins and the teacups. We have our china cups and saucers today for special people, and We're gonna, and we have the molasses, and we have butter, and I made a few little treats besides some nice mini cheesecakes with either caramel on the top or a raspberry little thing. I think you'll like them.
Don't forget the homemade cheese.
And the homemade cheese. Oh, my God. It's right there. Oh. Don't worry.
Wow.
We'll have that for sure. So.
That's what I'm afraid of.
I'm telling you, if you love homemade cheese, if you're from here and you love that, and it's a stinky thing, it's awful. Some people even throw it away. But it's the most delicious. And it's best when it's got veins in it of blue. And that's when it's aged to perfection, isn't it?
That's what she's got.
Mama used to make homemade cheese all the time. And people used to come and buy it from her. And it's It's just that the milk should put it on the stove and heat it up, and should sometimes you should add salt, and sometimes you'd have to use rennet, you know, depending on the time of the year it was. There's the bonnock, it's just ready. But and she would stir that until it came, it separated out, and there'd be curds. And she'd take the curds out from the rest of the whey, and she'd put it in a big strainer, and then put it in a pot, and she'd add salt to it, and stir it with her hand. That's our best mixing spoon. And she'd, you know, once she got all of the as much as she could of the whey out of it, Papa had made a frame, a wooden frame with a top and a bottom, and she'd cover it with cheesecloth, and she'd put all of this curds in there, and then put the cheesecloth all over the top, and then she'd have the wooden cover on it, and she'd put it out behind a shed that we had, where those big long boards that kind of almost like a spring board that was out there, and she would have the cheese out there, and just have a weight on it to squeeze out the extra whey. And I don't know how many days she would leave it. It might have been a week or two or something. Then she would take it in, and she would remove it and re-wrap it, and she'd have it in the cellar, like either on a rafter down in the cellar or hanging from the rafter, because you never knew what little travelers could be around in the old cellars, right? And then it would age like that, and it was so hard to stay away from. So that is the cheese we speak of, which is so hard to come by these days, but we have our sources, and we get a little gem, and a big cake, probably about 8 inches wide, will the whole wheel will cost you about $60. It's just delicious. So anyway, we're sharing. Cecil doesn't share his homemade cheese with anybody, but he gave in today. He said, well, we're going to give some to Teresa, so she's going to have some with her bonnock. So Rita, if you hold on a second, think about what you'd like to sing, but I'm going to bring the bonnock out of the oven before I burn it.
Mom did the same. Mom used to make it too.
Did she?
Oh, she did.
The homemade cheese.
Oh, the homemade cheese. Okay.
So there is our cooked bonnock. What do you think, Teresa? Does that look right?
Yeah, pretty good.
Pretty good. Well, there you go now. I'm just going to pop it out and put it on the cooling rack. And by the time she finishes the song, we'll get everybody to sit at the table.
Any requests? No.
You know what? I have a request.
I'll try.
Sarah,
if I can remember, do you remember the words?
I don't remember the words. Give it a try. Sarah.
I can try.
Yeah, Sarah. And I want to
excuse
talk to
the mistakes.
Maybe Sarah,
right?
The oldest one.
Is the
There's
song?
There's a few in my family too.
Is your CD? Is it still available anywhere?
I don't think
Lantern
so.
Lantern Burn?
It's kind of past the 20-year mark. I think it ran out.
Really? Oh, my God. Such a beautiful album. It was called Lantern Burn. Was that the one that CBC
kind both, of, actually. CBC.
They did both of them?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
I'll try. I'll get a verse or two in anyway. We'll see
yes.
how it goes.
Yeah, because do you remember this? I don't know if you remember this or not. No, I don't know that you were there, but we were all up at Minnie and Alex at a house party.
Yeah.
Do you remember this?
I think.
And the CBC guy that was working, producing the album, what was his name?
Glenn Meisner?
Yeah, Glenn Meisner. I don't know if it was him that was there or whatever. And I don't know if it was Dolores Boudreau that suggested... It was her. Maybe it was her that was there.
Yep.
And you guys had a lot of slow songs. Sorry. Had a lot of slow songs on that you were compiling ready for this
album, and he wanted something that was fast. And that I was there when that conversation took place with Dolores, and she was suggesting this song, Sarah, which was a lively song.
Yeah.
And it's such a nice little song. And they put it on the album, and it was just so good. But I wish you could still get that album somewhere. It was called Lantern Burn. And maybe it's, you know, maybe God knows where it shows up where you can hear it still, you know? I don't know. You guys should be doing that. Another one. Really? Those voices? That's a legacy for your children, even.
Yeah.
So, you give it a go. See if you can remember the words.
I came upon a charming girl, and Sarah is her name. Her parents want a husband with riches, wealth, and fame. I haven't a wealth and riches and fame. They never come my way. Until I went to visit my love and through the keyhole say, Sarah, Sarah, won't you come out tonight? Sarah, Sarah, the moon is shining bright. Put your hat and jacket on, tell your mother you won't be long. And I'll be waiting for you around the corner. The old woman. I can't remember the second verse.
I should know that.
I know. I should too. Yeah, I have that one.
Oh.
The old woman thought she killed me, and I let her think so too. As I lay there on the floor, I didn't know what to do. At last she said, he's alive, not dead. My girl, I'll let him wed. And up I jumped, says, thank you, ma'am. And to my girl I said, Sarah, Sarah, won't you come out tonight? Sarah, Sarah, the moon is shining bright. Put your hat and jacket on, tell your mother you won't be long. And I'll be waiting for you around the corner. Sarah, Sarah, won't you come out tonight? Sarah, Sarah, the moon is shining bright. Put your hat and jacket on, tell your mother you won't be long. And I'll be waiting for you around the corner.
Woo! I love that song.
I love it.
Okay, Teresa, we're going to move over to the table. And Rita, you take the middle chair. Teresa, you sit here at the end. And we're going to have some tea and Bonnach.
Dear, what the...
Do you notice I put the cheese near you?
Yeah, I noticed.
Just so you can see, I'm going to take the cheese. Doesn't look like much, but there's the cheese, and oh, I can smell it already, and it's aged to perfection. And we have some treats over here. I'll show you the treats because there's the Bonnach ready to be cut, and we have these lovely little morsels, have the molasses and the butter and the teacups. So we're ready to give a little toast. I'll actually bring you around to this end because we'll be saying goodbye shortly. See if I can do this. Sorry, people. I have to go. I have to do this, or else. You guys go ahead and have your.
We're sneaking the
cheese. Start your cheese and the tea. I've got to get this so that I can have it up on the table.
I had to get a piece before she ate it all.
Yeah, she, that's right. I'm telling you. And that's her second piece today. So she's doing good. There's 9 things to take apart here, people. I'm really sorry, but we'll get it. There now. Just about there.
Your tech guy took off.
My tech guy took off, I'm telling you. No help. Good help is hard to find. Oh, there's another one. Jeepers Moses. Okay, there now. I think that's it. We'll get
Okay. There now. Isn't that great company to be in? Now, you guys go ahead and start. And,
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cilantro, or... Now, did you say cilantro or swancha? Swancha or cilantro? Swancha. Mm-hmm. Well, a different little take on that. Okay, I'm going to cut the bonnach.
Do you want me to turn that towards it?
Yeah, see if I'm over here, and I will pull it over. So, Teresa, I'm just going to cut it like this.
Mm-hmm.
And I cut it like that, like a big piece of pie. And I'll make a mess of it. And then, oh, it's steaming hot. I know it's a little too early.
How long do you usually let it sit?
I would let it sit at least another 10 minutes.
Yeah, for sure.
You know? Because it'll be, there'll be a lot of moisture.
You didn't have it in an hour, did you?
No, there now. So that's nice and light there. Oh. I'm going to show everybody the piece. So Rita, you don't mind my hands. I'll put that there. Put that there. And I'm going to show them my piece in the camera so they can see the texture. Okay. So if you can see that, it's nice and light and fluffy. Now, obviously, it's a little tad moist because of us breaking it open earlier than we would normally. I would normally leave it about 15 minutes. Just like when you have a nice hot biscuit, and if you open it too soon. So I want to see what she's going to do with hers. So she's broken it apart with a fork. How does it taste?
Mmm.
Is it good?
Beautiful.
Now here's some butter. I'll get you a knife. I don't have a knife out there. And there's the molasses and the homemade cheese.
Oh boy.
There you go, my dear.
Excuse me.
How's that tea? Is it
right?
Are you past the test?
Perfect.
Right.
Okay. So there now. Now you're going to have she's going to put a little butter on there.
I'm following her lead.
Yeah. Just the very best. Oh my God. The traditions. The traditions. And are you going to put some molasses on it too?
Indeed.
There you go. Now, if I have molasses on mine, I'll need a bib. There. Now, that's the way it should be served.
That's the way.
There you go.
I guess I'll have to have some molasses then.
Yep. So, people.
There
hello.
You go.
This was a very special day for me. I'm, I'm huge... on tradition and passing on and learning from those who have so much to offer. And they don't probably, Teresa probably doesn't see herself as a teacher, but she is that in every way, shape, or form, not only in her baking, but in the way she has lived her life. She's such a beautiful soul.
Oh, yeah,
and buddy. You, yes, you are. She's loving the cheese over there. But I really appreciate her. It's hard to get people to come on camera. People just think, oh my God, I can't do that. But you can, and it's a gift to not only me, but to all of you and who her children and her grandchildren who are maybe some are watching today. I believe most of her children are watching today, so isn't that beautiful? And life is not without its tragedy. She loved all of her family, but she lost a dear daughter just a few years ago to cancer, her daughter Mary. And, we just have to move on and live life to the fullest and cherish those memories. So I want to thank you for joining in this traditional day with me. And I want to sincerely thank Teresa, but I want to thank as well the beautiful Rita Rankin, who has just the most beautiful voice as you have just experienced. And she's a beauty, and she's a beautiful singer as well. So, and it's so nice because I taught Rita's daughter, little daughter, step dancing when she was like 5 or 6, and the same with Teresa's granddaughter, Emily. And I taught you? Did I teach you? Oh my God.
Isn't that awful? I was in grade 4.
You were in grade 4. I'm getting old. But anyway, isn't it great to share this with everyone? And I hope if you're out there and you listened and watched today that you'll send lots of love so that I can share that with her family and certainly with Rita's family as well. And just know that I think of you all the time, all my week, I think of all of you out there and how this has become such a wonderful way to spend a Sunday. And it's just, everybody matters to me, but you especially. I hope that if you're alone, that you're doing okay and that this Sunday brings you joy. And to those who are fit and able and are able to share some of the goodness and the goodies that come from these recipes, that you will do that and share that love and food with others who will really appreciate it. And have an absolutely wonderful week. And thank you once again for joining. And I'll see you next Sunday when we're, as promised, I'll be making the multigrain bread with all of you. And I'll be sending out the ingredient list Wednesday or Thursday, so you can be ready for sure. So, I love you all. Love one another. Thank you. Bye-bye.